Hello, a big hello to you all. How are you, children? Now, yesterday I've explained the lesson Children at Work, and I've explained the both first and the second part of the lesson. Today I will be explaining the third part of the lesson. Now let's refresh. Now what we have stated in the first and second part, in short, I will be telling you. Suppose if you have missed that part, so you will be knowing at least something about what is there in the first and the second part of the lesson. So I told you that nowadays children are made to work and earn in different ways. Though we and our government is against the child labor, but in spite of all those rules and regulation, children are still there for working. You can see them working in the restaurant, you can see them working in the factories and in many other places. But do you think that all the children, they come because of their parents and it? No. Sometime the circumstances also persuaded them to work in different type of places. Now, such is the story of Vedu, a boy who was an 11-year-old and he ran away from home. It was not that he was working. He was also working with his sister. But the money which he used to earn was taken away by his father forcefully, simply because he had to have alcohol. He used to drink a lot. And when he never used to give money to him, he was beaten in a very cruel manner. So this was a thing which was not able, this Velu was not able to tolerate it. And he ran to Chennai. So, in this story that we have read, children are made to work and earn in different ways. Some of them help their family make a livelihood. Many run away from unhappy homes, like in the case of Velu. They need to support themselves. They don't go to school also. So I told you yesterday that Velu was an 11-year-old boy. He ran away from home. He was wandering around for hours before getting on a train to Chennai without ticket. He was not having enough money to buy the ticket also. The Kanyakumari Express pulled in at Chennai station. Velu got down and sat on a bench. Now for the first time he had seen so many people together with their luggage in that railway platform. The noise was terrible. He was feeling tired. He was feeling miserable and hungry because he did not had anything to eat from the last 2 days. He only had a piece of jaggery and peanuts. Jaggery is good and peanut is, I hope you know what is a peanut, moongfali. In his bundle he carried a shirt, a towel and a comb. Now he had a bundle in his hand in which he carried only a shirt and a towel and a comb. He had neither money nor ticket. Now he did not even had a money or nor he had a ticket. He tried to sleep on the floor near the door. He heard the rough voice of a girl around his own age. Now he was simply sitting near the floor of the door of the train. Suddenly he heard a rough voice of a girl who was also about his own age. The girl was carrying a big sack. She was putting a big banyan till knees. And what she was doing, she was a garbage picker. She was picking up plastic cups, putting them into the sack. Her name was Jaya. She sat down next to him, next to Velu, and she said she could find some food for him to eat because she had already judged that this boy had run away from his home. She stood up to go. Velu had nowhere else to go, so he ran after her. Now in that big city, Velu was not knowing anybody. He was not having any place to live. But since that girl, she talked to him, so he ran after her. The two got to the road. Now the two of them went towards the road. Smoke and dust made Velu's head spin. Now spin is dizzy, giddy, chakkar aana. He was feeling giddy because that place was having a lot of pollution, so smoke and dust made Velu's head spin. The girl dragged him to the other side of the street. She took him onto a bridge. Velu peeped over the railing. The road ran under him, ran to the city. Velu saw big buildings in the distance. So now, children, he came from a rural area. Now he can see lot of traffic, lot of huge buildings, okay, bridge and many other things which had never seen before, and of course crowds, traffic. Jay warned him not to get caught, otherwise he would be in jail. Now Jay told him many children they come and run to the city and they are caught and they are thrown in the jail, so he has to be very careful in the city. His bare feet burned on the hot road as he walked. Now he was not having slipper also. When he was walking on the road with bare foot, his leg was burning. His bare feet burned. Now they finally stopped in front of a big building. A marriage was going to be performed. Now Velu was very hungry and her friend Jaya was also a bit hungry. Now she knew that even if she will beg, she will not get a food. They were not having money, especially Velu. He did not even have a single penny in his pocket. So a marriage, she took him to the procession, marriage procession, where a marriage was going to be performed inside. Beside the hall was a garbage heap. Then she took him to the garbage heap. The girl picked up a crushed banana and a vada, which Velu ate unwillingly. Now Velu was not going to eat a food like this. But she told him that you will never get food here. We are not having enough money. So from where you will get the food? You have to manage with this only. So he had to eat that food unwillingly. He felt better. Then the girl went to home to drop her full bag and get another one. Velu also joined her, and he could see that how hard that girl was working. And in spite of that, she was not having enough money to buy a good food. Leave good food, she cannot even buy a ordinary food. She was picking the food from the garbage tin, from the dustbin, and she was eating it. So you can say how tough is their life, how hard is their life. Now Jay and Velu walked along the road and came to a bridge across a dirty drain. They came a row of huts built out of wood, plastic and sheet. It was Jaya's village. So it was a slum area. She dumped her sack there and gave him a pair of old shoes, a sack and a stick. He wondered what work she wanted him to do. She told him that they were rag pickers. Okay. They were rag pickers. The person who pick up all those things, plastics, waste materials, okay, and then waste papers, so and they sell it. So they collected things from rubbish bins, paper. They collected the things like paper, plastic, glass, okay. It was sold to Jaggu, and finally they sold to Jaggu. He was a junk dealer. Now Velu had no option. He decided to work as a rag picker until he found a better job. So the author wanted to say, such is the miserable life of the children. If they are weak in their financial, they are very weak, not having enough money, they are weak, their financial condition is not good, okay, and they have to lead such type of life. In case of Jaggu, he ran from home because he used to get a beating from his father in a very cruel manner. Though he used to earn, he and his sister used to earn, and they gave their money to their father, but then also he was not satisfied, he used to beat him, okay. So this was the whole first and the second part I revised with you, and today I'm going to read the third part. Now let's start with the third part. There is row of huts near some dirty puddles. Okay. Now, she took him to his house where she was living. Who? Jaya. Okay. And what he found, that they were row of houses. Row means line on the houses where they're in the line, the hut where they're in the lines. And puddles, near the puddles. Puddle is muddy pit. Okay, muddy pit, and lot of mosquitoes and flies are near that pit. Outside one of the huts, Jaya dumps her sack. Now, what she could go in one of the house, it seemed where she was living, she dumped her sack, or she must have gone to the house where Jaggu was living. Grateful to his friend, Velu thinks of the days ahead. Now he is very grateful that due to him, Jaggu, Velu is very grateful to her friend Jaya. She is very happy that due to her only he was able to get a company in a new city. At the same time, she helped her in getting the food also. So she was very thankful of that girl for new friend. But at the same time, he was thinking of the days ahead, that how nicely he and his sister were leaving, and he simply had to run away because his father used to beat him in a very cruel manner. Now, Jaya and Velu walked along the roads for half an hour until they came to a bridge across a dirty trickle of water. Now, Jaya and Velu, they walked along the roads for half an hour. So, for half an hour, Jaya and Velu, they walked upon the roads until they came to a bridge across a dirty trickle of water. Trickle is narrow stream. Okay. And this meaning I have not told you about this line. I think I have missed you this line. Days ahead, that means the days which is going to come, that is the future time. Okay. He was grateful to his friend Jaya, but at the same time he is thinking about that what life he will have here in this new city in the future. Now let's see what happened next. Jaya and Velu walked along the road for half an hour. Now again they had walked on the road, and you can see how that girl Jaya, she is working so hard, until they came to a bridge across a dirty trickle of water. Trickle, I told you, narrow stream. Okay, a ganda nali. We are in Trapliki again now. Now she told that he this area we are in Trapliki now. See, that's Buckingham Canal, said Jaya. Now she was making fun. Okay, she was telling him Trapliki now, she's telling that is a Buckingham Canal. This is a irony here, you can see. So now we are back to part 3 of this lesson, and let's read again. There is a row of huts near some dirty puddles. Alright. So, and outside one of the huts, Jaya dumps her sack, and she is grateful to his friend Velu, thinks of the day as ahead. Now, 3 points are here, that it is a place where Jaya is living near dirty puddles, and outside one of the huts there she goes and she dumps her sack. So there are 2 reasons. Either it must be the place where she sell her दैट गार्बेज. इट इज़ अ नेम, ए पर्सन नेम इज़ जग्गू हु बाय ऑल हर जंक. एंड सेकेंडली शी इट ऑल्सो, इट कैन ऑल्सो मीन हियर डैट शी इज़ गोइंग टू अ प्लेस ऑफ हर टू हर हाउस एंड शी इज़ टेकिंग रेस्ट फॉर अ वाइल एंड आफ्टर दैट शी विल गो टू जग्गूज प्लेस टू गिव ऑल द जंक्स विच शी हैड कलेक्टेड. Now, and in this part you will find that Velu is that Venu is grateful his friend Jaya, and he is thinking of the days ahead. That means for how he will lead his future life, what he will do in future. So let's start reading. Jaya and Velu walked along the roads for half an hour. That means for half an hour they walked along the road. Now you can see that how much hard work they were doing until they came to a bridge across a dirty trickle of water. We are in Triplicain now. See, that's Buckingham Canal, said Jaya. Now this line, it is a humorous line, and it also shows that Jaya was not only a hard working and laborious girl, but she was having a great sense of humor. Now Triplicain and Buckingham Canal is a place near, it is a place in London. So she is giving comment to that pool of water which is there near her house. She is telling, see, that is a Buckingham Canal. So she is making fun of that place. She is passing comments. So here we can see in the figure of speech is irony. How? Because she is passing a comment on that nala which is overflowing near her house, and she is telling that puddle of that dirty puddle is a Buckingham Canal. Velu stared. This was a canal. Near some puddles of water was a row of the strangest hut he had ever seen. Now he was staring hard at her, not able to believe. He is telling, is this a canal? Near some puddles of water was a row of strangest hut he had ever seen. Now Velu saw some of the hut which he had never seen earlier. It was a strange type of hut. It was a strange type of hut. They were built out of all sort of things: metal, sheets, tire, bricks, wood and plastic. So he had seen that huts, they were a special type of huts. They were not the huts which he had seen in his village. In his village, the huts were made of mud and it was covered with palm leaves. So these huts, they were some special type of hut. They were built with metal sheets, tires, bricks, wood and plastic. They stood crookedly and looked as if they would fall any moment. They were not standing erect also. They were not straight. They stood crookedly. Okay. The things were not arranged properly. Only it was kept. One thing was kept upon the other thing. The way it was kept, it was looking dangerous to Velu. He was thinking, it may fall any moment. Is this where you live? Now he was in a shock. He told, this is the place where you are living. These houses are strange. He told, this house is very strange, very dangerous, said Velu. In our village, the houses are made of mud and palm leaves. Now what he told, in our village, the house is made of mud and palm leaves. So you can see that Velu is surprised to see those types of huts, and he is comparing the huts which is there in his village. Jaya went around to one of the huts and dumped her sack outside. Now Jaya, in the meantime, she went in front of one of the huts and she dumped her sack outside. She kept her sack outside. Then she picked up an empty one. Okay. And then she took an other empty sack. Let's go. She turned to Velu and gave him a shove. Shove means push. She pushed Velu and she told him, let's go. at least help me now here where this wrestling, at least you must help me, I'm helping you so much, so it is also your duty to help me as a friend. Now she had offered him, she had given him a bag and a pair of shoes. She threw him a pair of old shoes without laces. So that pair of old shoes she threw to him, and those shoes were so old and they were without laces, and pushed a sack and a stick into his hand. Now she also gave him a sack and a stick on his hand. Velu was confused. Now Velu was not knowing why she is handing all this stick and sack in his hand. What work does she want him to do with this thing? Now she is telling him, what work will she do with this thing? The only work he had ever done was on the landowner's farm, weeding and taking cows out to graze. The only work he had ever done was on the landowner's farm, weeding and taking cows out to graze. Now what she is telling? She is telling that only work I have to do, that I used to work on landowner's farm, and there I used to do weeding on the farm, and after weeding I used to take cows out to graze. Now what do you mean by weeding? Weeding means removing the grass and the extra plants on from the field. So he told ki only work I have to do was I used to weed, and after that I used to take cows and cattle outside for grazing. Are there any farms in the city? He asked Jaya. Now he told ki, is there any farm in the city also? She laughed and thumped her stick on the ground. Farms? There are no farmers here. We are rag pickers. Now she laughed at his question and she bit her stick on the ground and she told ki, farm? You're talking about farm? Here you will not even see a farmer. We are rag pickers. Who are rag pickers? A person who picks garbage from the bin and then they sold those garbage to the junk dealer. Rag pickers. See my sack full of things I collected. You see, what is a rag picker? She told me, see, in my sack I have collected a lot of types of things. Collected from where? Asked Velu. From rubbish bin. Where else? Now he told me, from where you have collected all these things? She told me, I have collected all these things from rubbish bin. Where else I could go and collect? You collect rubbish? Velu had never heard of such a thing. Now Velu was surprised. He told her that you are collecting rubbish from the rubbish bin. I have never heard such type of thing. I, blockhead. It's not any rubbish. Only paper, plastic, glass, such thing. We sell it to Jam Bazaar, Jaggu. Now she told ki, for you it might be rubbish, but for me it is a thing. It is a paper, plastic, glass and such thing. And we sell all this thing to Jam Bazaar. Velu was puzzled. He had heard of people throwing away rubbish. Now he had heard of people who were throwing away rubbish. But why would anyone want to buy rubbish? Now he is telling ki, but why should anybody want to buy rubbish? Who is Jam Bazaar Jaggu? Why he is buying all this? Now at the same time, Jaggu was puzzled when he heard the name Jam Bazaar. He told her that who is Jam Bazaar? Why he is buying all this thing? You think he buys it for show? He sell it to a factory. Come on, I don't have time to waste like you. Now she told Jaggu that I'm selling this thing to get some money, and that fellow, that Jaggu, he will sell those things to the in a factory. So he is telling, that's why, this is the reason that why I'm selling all this thing to him. Afterward, he will give me a little amount of money, and I will be taking that money to the to my house, and he will get more money, and in this way we will get some money to fulfill our basic needs. You think he buys it? For sure he sells it to a factory. Come on, I don't have time to waste. Like, well, he did not move. He hadn't run away and come to this new place to dig through garbage bin. Now, Velu, he was not able to move. He never thought in a dream that one day he had to do such type of work. He has to dig through garbage bins. He hadn't run away and home for this new place to dig this garbage bin. Jaya poked him with a stick. She is indicating him. She is telling him to come to work fast. Look here, she shouted. If someone gets there before us, we don't get anything. Now, at the same time, she told Jagu that if anybody will come before us, then we will not get even a single thing. The other people will take the thing. So we have to hurry up and we have to collect those things. Look here, she shouted. If someone gets there before us, we don't get anything. Don't just stand there posing, big hero. I'm trying to help you. Who filled your stomach today? He told ki, don't stand. Don't refuse me what I'm saying to you. Don't stand like a hero, but come to do some work. Otherwise, it is very difficult here to survive. Nobody will help you every day. Nobody will give you, provide you food every day. And today I filled your stomach, but who will do the next time? Velu scratched his head and sighed. Sigh means he took a deep breath. I will do it for now, he thought, until I find a better job. Now, the decision Jagu has taken that till for the time being, he will do this job of garbage picking. And finally, I will find a better job ultimately, and then he will leave all this thing. Okay, so this was a decision taken by Jagu. So children, what is the message of the story? What is the central idea? In fact, what the writer wanted to tell to us, he wanted to tell to us that there are many ups and downs in a person's life. Nobody will lead his life happily forever. He has to face happiness also. He has to face sadness also. So this life is not a bed of roses. He had to go through many ups and downs in his life, like Jagu, now that, like that Velu and that girl was having. But we have to face it bravely. You can see those kids, Velu and Jaya, they were too young. Instead of playing with the toys, instead of going to the school, they have become rag pickers. And of course, they were facing their life very boldly, without grumbling, without complaining. They were ready, willing to do the hard work. And even Velu, he don't have any option, because for survival and for hunger, he needs some money. Now, every day, her friend will not give him money and food. So, this is the message the poem want to give, that we have to face whatever we get from life. If we are getting happiness, fine, we will be happy. But if we are sad, then also we have to face it boldly, without complaining anyone. So this is the central idea of this lesson. Now let's see the question answers. What material are the strange huts made out of? Now, when Velu came to the place where that girl Jaya was living, he was surprised. He had seen the huts in his village, which was nice, though it was made of mud and palm leaf was there. But he admired those huts. On the contrary, the huts which he had seen where Jaya was living, it was something very strange. It was built of tin sheets, bricks, woods and plastic. and it was also not arranged in a proper way. It might fall any moment. So these hurts were a bit strange from the hurt which he had seen in his village. Why does Velu find them strange? Velu find those hurts strange because in his own village the hurts were made of mud and palm leaf. It was made with mud and palm leaf, and it was in a proper manner. Everything was arranged, put in an arranged way. Unlike the hearse which he had seen is in the place where Jay was living, that it those hurt may fall any moment. What sort of thing did Jaya and children like her collect, and what did they do with those things? Now, question number two, what sort of thing did Jaya and children like her collect, and what did they do with those things? So Jaya and other children like her, they collected paper, they collected plastic, they collected glass from the garbage bin, and they sold all this thing to a kabadi or a junk dealer. Now Jaggu was a junk dealer where Jaya used to go and sell the, and she used to sell those things. So now the last question, is Velu happy or unhappy to find work? Give reason for your answer. Well, what I feel, Velu is not at all happy. He is not at all happy. He had never done such a dirty job in his village. He was dreaming to do a good job, but due to some circumstances and without any studies, without any education, without any professional knowledge, he knew that he will not get any job. So he had to do the job which was given to him, by Jaya. He thought it is much better to do this instead of starving. Now please go through the question answer of the next question is exercise, and please try to do by yourself. Okay, is Velu a smart boy? Now I will give you some hint. No, he was not a smart boy. Why? That you have to find out. Do you think Jaya is a brave and sensitive girl? Yes, and she had a sense of humor also. Write that dirty trickle of water, Buckingham Callum. Give this example. And she also had a kind nature because she was helping, and she provided food to Velu. What one throws away as waste may be valuable to others. Do you find the sentence meaningful in the contents to this story? How? Yes. Now I will tell you the answer of this. Yes, the plastic, the paper and rusty metal sheets thrown away by the people become valuable to rag pickers. Full stop. They eat leftover food for survival. They sell junk food to some dealer to earn their livelihood. So in this manner, what is happening? This food, the way they fill their tummy, okay, and they eat the leftover food for their survival. Okay, so what one throw become as a waste become available for others. In this way they earn their livelihood. So I've discussed all the questions with you, and with this I end my lesson here. Go through it, listen to my other videos, and the doubts you can ask in the classes which I will be having today or tomorrow. Thank you and have a nice day.